Hello, hello. This is Adelaide Brown, your heart coach, and I just wanted to stop by today and just share some encouraging words with you. I know that our country and our world, for that matter, is going through a lot of transition and redirection and just change that we have never experienced before. And I just wanted to come by and just take some time to encourage you, to uplift you, and to also challenge you. As we move forward in the next couple of days and weeks and months, I am your heart coach. And as a heart coach, I work with individuals to confront matters of the heart, mental and emotional conflicts and issues, so that they can live authentically on purpose. And I feel like in a time like this, when anxiety is high and frustration and fear is just looming, I feel like we have to be very clear about the state that we're in mentally, spiritually, and emotionally, as well as physically, so that we can best combat what's going on right now with the coronavirus, COVID-19, and all of the fear and just hysteria that is breaking out. I have been thinking about this whole idea of us being tested and being approved. I was reading John chapter 6, verse 6, and it was when Jesus fed the 5,000. And during that time, he had asked, I think it was Andrew, he said, well, how are we going to feed them? And it said, right after he asked him that question, it said Jesus was testing him to prove him. And I believe that we're in a season right now where we're being tested to prove who and what we are and what we're made of. This is especially towards the body of Christ and those who say that they believe in Jesus Christ, that he died and was born again. And I just want to take this time to say, I do believe that you're being tested, I'm being tested, and I believe that we're going to be proved. I feel like there have been many times that you probably felt less than, you felt unworthy, you felt like you didn't have a reason for being here, you weren't important. But the thing about that is, you're still here. There are people dying, there are things changing, the world is just ever shifting, but you're still here to make an impact, and I just really want to encourage you to do that in this season. This is a season where we're being tested about how we feel about ourselves and those who are closest to us. The things that we love to do the most, as far as entertainment, movies, sports, big gatherings, all of those things right now are being canceled, and we're having to go home. They're asking us to practice social distancing. And we already live in a world where social media is, it seems to be king, but we have depression and anxiety at an all-time high. So I really believe that we're being tested in this time to come back to ourselves, to get to know ourselves, to learn to love ourselves. We have been so distracted. We have been able to run from who we are by staying busy with work and with other responsibilities. Those of us in the church, we talk about being believers. A lot of times we won't deal with our own issues and our own circumstances in life because we're so busy taking care of the church or feeding the homeless or helping youth and mentoring. And I'm talking about all the things that I've done, but a lot of those things I did in different seasons of my life because I was trying to avoid dealing with the issues that were within. The issues, the pains, the hurts that were causing me to want to help those who were less fortunate than I. A lot of times we want to help people who are less fortunate because that's the only way we find strength and worth. And in this season of us practicing social distancing, I'm encouraging you to practice spiritual intimacy. Spiritual intimacy. I'm encouraging you to do that. That's the second thing. When we were uplifting, now we're in encouraging. I'm encouraging you to practice spiritual intimacy in a time of social distancing. Do you have a song in your heart? Do you have words or scriptures in your mind that you can meditate on? Do you have dreams and desires and aspirations that you've been wanting to invest time in? Now is the time for you to work towards those things. It is not the time for you to sit at home and watch the news all day and get worried and make yourself sick. You wash your hands, you don't touch your face, your eyes, your nose as much as possible, and you get to work. Not out at work, not on the clock, but you get to work on you. You use this time to get to know you and to love yourself, and that's the challenge. I challenge you to find ways to love others. Sit down and journal. Get to know who you are. Do a reset. Reflect over your life. Stop going from one thing to the next thing to the next thing. Instead, just slow down and say, you know what? I'm going to work on me. I'm going to figure out who I am. I'm going to be the best that I can be. And stay focused on that. Okay, so that's just something I really wanted to share with you guys today. Make sure to like or subscribe, like the video, subscribe to the channel so that when I upload new things, you can get notifications. I am committed to making sure that I encourage consistently, because I believe that all of us need it, and I truly believe that now is the time. So I just want to encourage you. I just want to let you know that I'm praying for you, and I ask that you please share this video with anyone that you think could benefit from this. Remember that no weapon formed against you shall prosper, and that's physically, mentally, spiritually, biomedically, biochemically, whatever it is. You put your faith in Jesus Christ, and He will bring you through. Trust and believe that. So you think about that. This is Adelaide Brown, your heart coach with Addie BB and the Heart Connections. And I will talk to you guys later. Love y'all. Have a great day.